Hit it, CC. You're watching Crank It Up Rock.
Hello folks, welcome to Crank It Up Rock. I'm your host, Jared Running Jr., and today we will be talking about the top 11 rock one-hit wonders. Just so we're clear, this list has no specific order, really. I'm not claiming any song is bigger or better than any others on the list, or that I didn't include. I just chose a list of 11 songs that are one-hit wonders in my mind, and I'm going to rank those based on peak position on the Billboard Hot 100. But I do realize that can leave people questioning how this song is higher than that. So I just wanted to address that out of the gate. Obviously, I guess that is kind of ranking them. But I'm not claiming 11 isn't a bigger or better song in the long run of things. I'm just saying it charted lower. So, all right, guys, let's get into it. Number 11, Smooth Criminal Alien Ant Farm. A cover of the 80s classic Michael Jackson song. In 2001, Alien Ant Farm would cover the track in what would become their biggest taste of success, peaking at number 23 in the United States on the Billboard Hot 100. And according to lead singer Dryden Mitchell, the band would play a few riffs of the Jackson song while warming up before gigs, and the audience members would request them to play the entire song. The positive feedback would lead to them finally recording the song for themselves, including it on their sophomore album, Anthology. Number 10, Mississippi Queen, Mountain. Reaching 21 in the Billboard Hot 100 at its height right at the start of the 1970s, this is considered a rock classic and is easily the height for Mountain. For me, this was a no-brainer on a list of the biggest rock one-hit wonders. How do you leave this song out? Of course, it's iconic. If you don't know it, you do, essentially. Number 9, Stacy's Mom, Fountain of Wayne. End argument here. Peaking at number 21 on the Billboard Hot 100, this is quite obviously Fountain of Wayne's biggest song, and without a doubt is a one-hit wonder. This feels like one that everyone coming into this was expecting. You know, do I have to make an argument for it? If I'm going to, obviously it's been ranked top rock songs of the 2000s is on there. I seen a list, best rock songs to come out since you were born. Nope. but no, it's clearly, it's their only hit. It's a huge hit. Everybody knows it. Duh. Number 8, Black Betty, Ram Jam. Originally a Lead Belly song, Ram Jam's Bill Bartlett would take the 59-second arrangement and create the song we know today. Releasing it 3 years after recording, it would go on to be a hit, going all the way to number 18 on the Billboard Hot 100. Obviously, I see these songs, I'm like, oh, do I need to... No. You guys know these songs. And if you don't, I'm gonna say it every time. If you don't, yes, you do. Yes, you do. These are all bona fide hits. If it's on here, you've heard it somewhere. You've heard Black Betty. It's played everywhere. Even the most under the rock person has heard it one time in their life at some point somewhere. Number 7, Cult of Personality, Living Color. Cult of Personality peaked at number 13 on the Billboard Hot 100. Of course, it has since gained a second life through its inclusion in the GTA San Andreas soundtrack, and even more notably for me, as former WWE and current AEW stars CM Punk's theme song since 2011. It's fair to say this is Living Color's peak to this day. Still living on it. It's still all over. You still hear it. As I said, AEW, CM Punk, GTA, San Andreas, it's all over. It's very clearly their biggest hit. It's the only Living Color song that you're gonna get people to name. It's if you asked 100 people, 100 people are going to say Cult of Personality, or they're not going to say anything. Number 6, Tainted Love, Soft Shell. Originally recorded by Gloria Jones in 1964, Tainted Love took off after being covered in 1981 by Soft Shell. Peaked at number 8 on the Billboard Hot 100, Soft Shell's version of Tainted Love ranked number 5 on VH1's 100 Greatest One-Hit Wonders of the 1980s. So I'm not going to sit here and justify it being included as a one-hit wonder, because that does it right there. Obviously, it's a one-hit wonder. Number 5, The Final Countdown, Europe. Quite possibly the biggest in terms of knowing the song. Everybody knows this song. It might be the final countdown on this list, but it's only at number 5 because it did not peak the highest. A must-have on a list of rock one-hit wonders, with its iconic keyboard opening, you damn well know this song from the jump. The Final Countdown peaked at number 8 on the Billboard Hot 100 in the United States, as well as reached number 1 in 25 countries, including Europe's home nation, Sweden. Number 4, All-Star, Smash Mouth. Well, maybe not necessarily your cut-by-the-numbers one-hit wonder. I'm going to make an argument All-Star is the only sustained success Smash Mouth has ever seen. I'm going to go out on a limb with this because it reached number 4 on the Billboard Hot 100. And now it's living on as a meme born out of its inclusion in the DreamWorks 2001 Shrek film. All I have to say is hit since 1998, Smash Mouth 1. Bryce Harper, 1400. If you know what I'm talking about, you know. Number 3, Lips of an Angel, Hinder. Maybe a controversial choice, as charting-wise, this song rose up the pop charts, not the rock charts. But I will not be hearing any of that, as Extreme Behavior is a rock album and Hinder is a rock band. So therefore, if they both fit into the rock category, the song off the rock album by a rock band is going to count as a rock one-hit wonder. Going all the way up the Billboard Hot 100 to number 3, how can you leave a song off a list screaming for some additional top 5 charting songs when it's maybe a pop song by some people's definitions? It's not. And it's a top 3 charting song from a rock band. We're including it on the rock one-hit wonders. If you want to take it up with me that it shouldn't be on here, the comments are open. If you really want to tell me it's a pop song, go for it, I guess. But I would rather you argue it's not a one-hit wonder, if anything. Number 2, Take On Me, Aha. Topped the Billboard Hot 100 at its peak back in 1985. Take On Me is a song that has endured the ages. I'd say it's fair to qualify it as a song of the 80s, as the music of the decade, and Take On Me will forever be entangled. This is a song that, if the Final Countdown is not the biggest song on here, the song that everybody knows, it would be Take On Me. It's those two. Take your pick. But Take On Me happened to chart higher in the United States on the Billboard Hot 100. And the Billboard Hot 100 is what we're going off, not the charts in so-and-so country. So if you think that Take On Me is bigger because it charted higher in the United States, I'll give you that argument. That's fair. But let's move on to number 1. Number 1, maybe controversial, Hey There Delilah, Plain White Tees. A song of a generation for people around my age and older. How could I pass on the opportunity to include this song? By a far margin, Plain White Tees' highest rated song is atop the Billboard Hot 100 for 2 weeks at its height. This one is somewhat controversial, with other songs like Rhythm of Love and 1-2-3-4 as fringe by the definition hits, but I ultimately chose to include it because if you asked 100 people for their biggest hit, if you go Man on the Street. What's Plain White Tee's biggest hit? 95 are going to say Hair There Delilah. And 5 will say Who Are the Plain White Tees? If you want to argue that, then I would say you're a hipster that would just not say Hey There Delilah to be different. But it's like charting wise, clearly far and above their biggest hit. And when you can look at the Billboard Hot 100 and go, well, maybe this song is by definition a hit, but if it didn't move up another spot, it wasn't a hit. I'm not going to really get into that. I'm not going by definition has to be in the top 40 to be a hit. I'm more going like, if it's a hit, you know it's a hit. Because there is bands that were included on this list that had a song that reached the top 20 or the top 15, but it wasn't a hit. It didn't have any sustained success. So can you really go, well, Rhythm of Love was 38. Okay. If you want me to take Plain White Tees off because of that, then we're going to have to go and look through this entire list with a fine-tooth comb. And you're not going to want to talk about how this song that was clearly a hit and is clearly a one-hit wonder isn't, because by definition they had another hit. Nobody knows it, but it was a hit. So, yeah. But in conclusion, folks, I want to hear what you guys think. What are some one-hit wonders that come to mind for you with the rock genre that I did not include here? Because obviously I included 11. I couldn't include every one-hit wonder. There's one-hit wonders I took off the list. I had like a list of 15, 20 one-hit wonders, and then I cut it down to 11. So there's some that I even thought about including that I didn't include. Hey, how about Guns N' Roses, Van Halen? Because yes, folks, I seen those bands somehow on list of one-hit wonder bands. They're not even one-hit wonder in terms of on an album. But hey, maybe you guys want to make an argument why they should be on the list. Go for it, I guess. But I've been Jared, and I will see you guys in the next video. All right.